Hello, everyone. Hope you had a great week. We're back again with another episode of the UFO Planet News Report. We have six sightings to share with you today that include sightings from Greece and one from Kandahar, Afghanistan. All the action gets started in 35 seconds. Our first story comes from Tempe, Arizona. On February 12th, some dude decided to gaze out the kitchen window and happened to notice some strange lights in the night sky. He says he always looks into the night sky in the general direction of what he filmed. This time, it was different.
So I'm out here recording some kind of lights in the sky. You can see them over there in the distance. Not making any sound, I don't know what that is. Look at that. Look at those lights. Sit right here. I think one just disappeared, I don't know. It's one, two, three, it's four lights, four of them.
The observer says he has never seen anything like this, especially in that part of the sky. At one point, an airplane traveling east went in the general direction of the objects. The UFO did not seem affected by the aircraft nearby. The observer recorded two clips because he thought the event had ended, but more objects returned. The cell phone camera did not do the objects justice, as the shooter reports that they had a reddish-orange color. On camera, they tend to appear as white lights. Uncertain as to what he was looking at, the observer has submitted the footage to experts who will attempt to examine and explain the footage. What's the first thing that goes through your mind when someone claims to have witnessed a boomerang UFO? Two football fields in size. Exactly. We thought so too. Especially when the sighting took place in a populated area and the only proof supplied is an artist rendition of the craft. One would think that in this day and age where everyone has a camera in their pocket, at least one person would have captured the UFO on film. Well, we aren't that lucky, it appears. But let's check out the story and see what the alleged observer had to say. Here is the explanation according to the observer who witnessed a huge UFO near Long Beach, California. While doing my exercise in my backyard, I paused to look at the sky for Orion's Belt and other stars. I then look northeast and see a boomerang-shaped craft about the size of two football fields side by side. I thought it was too wide to be a military plane, and those make a ton of noise. I could not see the fuselage nor red or blue lights at the wingtips. The lights, they remained constant. The outline towards the back was dim even before going off in the distance. The craft's speed was consistent. It did not speed up, nor did it slow down. And that's what the observer had to say. Well, any chance weed is legal in California now? I mean, hey, don't get me wrong. I think this sighting would be absolutely fascinating, to say the least. However, if a picture is worth 1,000 words and there are 30 pictures in every second of video, imagine how awesome a few seconds of video would have been. Keep those cameras handy, hey, and put the weed down. Have you ever wondered if time machines exist? The submitter of this story claims the object captured in a photo may be just that. The photo you are looking at was taken from a moving vehicle in La Habra, California on February 15th. The observer thought they were looking at an alien spacecraft, but someone online told them it looks a lot like a time machine. And well, we all know how social media investigations go. Whomever has the best imagination wins, right? The experts on the UFO Planet team are not so easily convinced. There is a general consensus that the photo captured a reflection from the instrument panel inside the car. However, the photo's not really clear enough to say for sure. Whenever someone notices something in a photo that they never noticed while taking the photo, it should immediately draw suspicion and warrant further detailed examination by qualified experts. Sadly, that is not the norm in the social media UFO community. In most cases, investigations rely more on imaginations than science. In recent years, UFO investigators have noticed a huge increase in the number of UFO submissions of easily identifiable objects and blame it on the desire for people to get shares and likes on their social media posts, all the while damaging the reputation of qualified investigators and turning the study of UFOs into a comedy. The observer who submitted this story from Kandahar, Afghanistan, appears to struggle with the English language, leaving us wondering if maybe English isn't their first language. As an example, they described the object captured on film as, and I quote, "hypersonic flying object with aerodynamical features that cannot exist with actual physics fluid laws." We really have no idea what that means, but it sure sounds important. The observer went on to speculate that the object uses magnetism as its method of propulsion, saying there was no sound, even though it was flying at many times the speed of sound, well, at least according to the shooter. After saying the object made no sound, the observer contradicted himself, saying sound reverberation was captured by the camera through a thick windshield where the camera was attached. A reverberation or reverb is created when a sound or signal is reflected, causing numerous reflections to build up and then decay as the sound is absorbed by the surfaces of the objects in the space. They could include furniture, people, and even air. The observer's explanation didn't end there. He went on to explain, and once again I quote, "digital hue definition camera captured a video that human eyes were unable to capture by itself." So was the human eye unable to see the object, or did they just not notice it as it passed in front of the camera at a high rate of speed? We asked the UFO Planet experts to chime in on this one. They thought that the object looked like an eagle, flying with its wings spread, and so we decided to compare. Here is the object in Kandahar with an eagle in flight next to it. Do you follow our experts in thinking that this is just a bird, or do you think something more sinister is going on in Afghanistan, where the Americans have been waging war for more than 18 years? Let us know what you think in the comments. Our next story takes us south of Luke Air Force Base in the Litchfield Park, Arizona area. The observer was driving southbound around 72 kilometers per hour when he noticed a stationary object in the sky to his right. He instantly took out his cell phone to record the event. According to the observer, this was not a flight from the Luke Air Force Base, as Luke radar approach control was closed at the time the video was recorded. We were only able to find one light in the video, but the observer says there were more. He says the lights appeared not to be connected to each other, but separate individual lights. A buddy of the shooter was driving a few cars ahead of the observer when the footage was captured. Once he was done recording, he called his buddy to ask if he had seen the object. He said no, as he had not been looking for it. Around that time, the observer's car went down a hill and their view was blocked by buildings and trees. Once they emerged from the valley, the object had disappeared from view and was no longer visible in the sky. Our final story today comes from Tarzana, California. The observer was driving to get dinner, made a left turn onto Ventura Boulevard from Reseda, and happened to look up because there was an obvious glowing object with beautiful colors, unlike anything she had ever seen.
It's like that thing.
The observer says she knew right away it was unusual, and after looking at it, knew it had to be a UFO. She described it as a cube-shaped object, solid in nature, moving very slowly to the southeast. It had a beautiful bright light that surrounded the whole craft and was constantly changing colors. The colors faded into each other. The sighting left the woman completely in awe and very excited. Unfortunately, the left turn onto Ventura meant the observer was now moving away from the object, and she decided it would not be a good idea to sit in the middle of the intersection to record more video. All we have is 14 seconds of raw footage to come to a conclusion. Any ideas? We'd love to hear from you. Well, that sure didn't take long. We already have the first UFO photo from NASA's Perseverance Mars rover that landed on the red planet just recently on February 18th. Someone thinks they have spotted something unusual in the very first image beamed back to the Earth by the new rover. This is what the submitter had to say about the photo. To the left of center of the photo, in the skyline, is a speck. Now, it's very small, but I'm having a hard time explaining it. I've never seen specks of dust or debris show up in the skyline in any other photos sent back from the rovers. Even the pictures of dust devils don't show any bits as pronounced as this speck. Thought it might be worth looking at. Well, it's always good to look and do some investigation, but you need to look pretty hard to find the speck that the submitter is referring to in this photo. Even on a 65-inch monitor, the speck is difficult to find. We're not going to hazard a guess as to what we are looking at, except to remind viewers that the rover had just landed in a cloud of Mars dust before this photo was snapped. There is a strong possibility that the speck is nothing more than dust that ended up on the lens during the landing. The speck is so small, not much larger than 1 or 2 pixels, that there is not enough information to make an educated guess. And we have to remember that sometimes people try way too hard to make UFOs out of absolutely nothing. That's it for this episode of UFO Planet News Report. I hope you'll join me again on Wednesday and then again on Sunday, twice a week, here on UFO Planet, where we look at the latest UFO submissions from around the planet. I'm Darren Crapo. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. Appreciate your support, and I will see you again next time.